Think ye ever step in time? Think ye ever step in time? Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. Think ye ever step. Oh my!
It's happened. The chairman wants to see me at the close of business tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going to come with you and I'll jolly well give your chairman a piece of my mind.
That would only make things worse. We need to face it. In just a few hours, I have joined the ranks of the unemployed.
Oh, George, are you quite sure?
Quite sure. So we need to make a plan. In fact, I'm afraid the time is... Was that vase?
You mean your mother's vase?
Yes, that one.
Oh, Mrs. Brill!
Yes, ma'am.
Where's my mother's vase?
Well, you see, I was dusting, and Roberts and I, and when...
Are you serious?
Well, Mrs. Brill, let's go to the kitchen, shall we? You'd better sit down.
Your world's gone topsy-turvy.
Mr. Banks, I found these really hard cookies up in the attic. Don't really know what they are, but...
Well, I never. So that's where I put them.
What are they?
Stars. Gingerbread stars I had once for my nanny. I always knew I'd put them where no one else could find them, but I didn't know why would he find them either.
Well, they're very bright, I guess you could say.
Aren't they? Even after all this time. It's funny. I used to dream that when I'd grow up, I'd know everything there was to know about the stars. I haven't thought about all that in years. I'm usually not so sentimental.
It's good to look back sometimes.
Is it? I'm not so sure. Thank you. A man has dreams of walking with giants, to carve his niche in the edifice of time, before the mortar of his zeal has the chance to congeal. The cup is dashed from his lips, the flame is snuffed a morning, he's brought to rack and ruin in his prime.
Well, life's a rum go, Governor. It's all there is to it. The truth.
You know what I think? It's Mary Poppins. From the moment she stepped into this house, things began to happen to me. My world was calm, well-ordered, exemplary. Then came this person with chaos in her wake. And as my life's ambitions go, with one fell blow, it's quite a bitter pill to take. It's that Poppins woman. She's responsible for all of this.
I know the very woman. And what's that thing she's always saying? A spoonful of sugar, that is all it takes. It changes bread and water into tea and cakes. A spoonful of sugar goes a long, long way. So have yourself an healthy helping every day.
A healthy helping of trouble, if you ask me.
Like you say, Governor, you've got to grind, grind, grind at that grindstone. Though childhood slips like sand through a sieve, and all at once they've up and flown, and then they've grown. It's too late for you to give just that spoonful of sugar to help the medicine go down. The medicine go down. medicine come down. Well, good luck, Governor. You're gonna need it.
Thank you, Bert. And good luck to you, too.
Father?
Yes?
We've come to say goodnight.
Ah, yes. Good night.
Daddy, do you remember when we came to the bank?
Yes.
Well, we were each given 6 pence, and we were told to spend them carefully.
Excellent advice. And that's exactly what you should do. So, what did you buy with them?
Nothing yet. We've kept them. But now we've decided to give them to you.
I suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this?
No, she hasn't said a word about it. But we know that things have been difficult for you lately, and we haven't really been much help.
So we thought a little extra cash might loosen things up a little.
It's a whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you, you know.
Good night, Daddy.
Jane, do you remember when you asked me who Neelys' father was?
Yes.
It was Poseidon, king of the sea. Good night.
He loves you, and that's far more important than jobs or houses or anything else.
Are you going to the bank with him?
I wish, but he won't let me. If only there were someone to stand up for him, to take his side, to show them what he's really like.
Well, why can't he do that for himself?
Because he's a man, and a very proud one.
Then you must go.
I'm afraid that's impossible.
Why?
Because I'm a woman.
Well, Mary Poppins says that anything can happen if we can only get out of our own way.
Do you really believe that, Mary Poppins?
Anything can happen if you let it. Sometimes things are difficult, but you can bet it. Doesn't have to be so.
Changes can be made.
You can move a mountain if you use a larger spade.
Anything can happen, it's a marvel.
You can be a butterfly.
Or just stay larval.
Stretch your mind beyond fantastic. Dreams are made of strong elastic.
Take some sound advice and don't forget it. Anything can happen if you let it.
I wonder. Anything can happen if you let it. You won't know a challenge until you've met it.
No one does it for you.
No one but yourself. Vacillating violets get left up on the shelf. Anything can happen, just imagine.
That shall be my epitaph. I wear the badge in honor of these world free thinkers.
Those who see beyond their blinkers.
Jelly isn't jelly till you set it.
Anything can happen if you let it. If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we found a whole new spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars. Learning
Tuppence a bag. Be the bird, sir. Only tuppence a bag.
I would take it as a great favor if you would kindly feed them for me.
Thank you. Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
Precision and order.
Here. Come in, Banks. Well, Banks, how did it happen? You turned down a scheme that was bound to make millions, and we want to know why.
Well, then I'll tell you. I refused Mr. Von Hustler because the scheme was hollow. It had no product, no substance, and no meaning outside the walls of a bank. He told me of his assets and his profit and his growth, but he never spoke a word about people. Now, I know if a man puts any value on real life, then as far as you're concerned, he's a washout. But I'm afraid I do value his gentleman. In short, George Banks, Esquire, has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining the bank, but I do not apologize for realizing that there are more important things in life than making money.
Ruining the bank. Ruining the bank. Ruining the bank, my dear chap, what are you talking about? You've saved our bacon. Haven't you heard? Von Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. You've kept us out of the nastiest scandal since records began. We're not asking for your apologies, we're offering ours.
Oh my word.
And then another thing, do you remember giving a loan to a fellow called Northbrook? Well, he's repaying it and opening two new factories. With the percentage you negotiated, we look set to make a fortune.
Oh my word.
Well, that's just it. We hope you might tell us how you did it. Just give us the word. It'll be quite safe with us.
Give you the word? Give you the word? Oh, I'll give you the word, all right. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you're always that precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Now, thanks.
Oh, please forgive him. It's not his fault. It's all because of his nanny, Miss Andrew.
The Holy Terror. She taught me everything I know.
Well, now's your chance to forget it.
That's right. And if you want to fight about it, you've come to the right woman.
No, no, it's all right. It's all right, Winifred. I haven't lost money at all. I've actually made the bank a fortune.
Really?
Madam, if you please, we still have some business to discuss. Ah, well, thanks. George, by way of recompense, we'd like to offer you the position of senior manager with a salary at double your present rate.
Exactly how much money has he made you?
Triple. Quadruple your present rate.
Close your mouth, George. We're not a caught fish.
Well?
Well, you must realize one thing from now on. My family comes first.
Agreed?
Agreed.
Winifred, I'm afraid I've underestimated you. How can you ever forgive me?
Oh, George, how can you ask?
Well, it was selfish of me to keep you off the stage. I know you'll want to go back, and I won't mind if you do.
Oh, no. I loved it, but I found a role I much rather prefer, and it's going to keep me very occupied for a long time.
Mary Poppins, Cornelius and Poseidon will live happily ever after, won't they?
Well, of course.
Oh, Mary Poppins, that was the best yet, to be up in the heavens. Do you think we'll ever go back there?
Yes, one day.
Really? Will it be soon?
Oh, no, not, I'm afraid. But you can always look up to the stars when you miss it. I think that this might help a bit.
But it's your telescope.
So it is. It's a gift.
Thank you.
Now, run along home.
I love you, Mary Poppins.
You're a fine boy, Michael Banks, and one day You'll be a fine man.
Oh, Mary Poppins, it makes me so anxious when you talk like that.
Like what?
So nice and kind, and not a bit like yourself. Be cross, Mary Poppins. Do be cross again.
Is that the thanks I get for all the...